My name is Brian Jennings. I think what I love about surfing is just being in God's creation. The first time I rode that first wave, I was just a little kid and just fell in love with the feeling of actually riding a wave. I first got into surfing actually just right here on this beach, just riding my my boogie board when I was a little kid, about 8 years old, and I started standing up on my boogie board, and I'm like, this is better. And then I just grabbed a surfboard and I just fell in love with it. It was, once I rode that first wave, it was like, no going back to the boogie board. I want to stand up every time. I think surfing became more to me when I was 14 years old. I started surfing in contest and realized I actually could do pretty well. And I was winning some of the local competitions and like, wow, this is cool. I'm actually pretty good at this. I learned really quick that I needed something more. I came to a place where I had had enough of the high school parties and drinking and sex before marriage and just anything I could like fill my heart up with. It just left me empty. In my room, just kind of prayed a simple prayer like, God, if you're real, I just want you in my life, you know? And I opened up my Bible and I opened it up to Isaiah chapter 1 verse 18, where it says, if you're willing and obedient, you'll inherit the best of the land. But if you resist and rebel, you'll be devoured by the sword. And I was like, whoa. If you resist and rebel, you'll be devoured by the sword. And I kind of already felt like I'd been devoured because I'd been resisting, you know? And so I'm like, well, I'm going to try that other part. Like, you know, like maybe if I'm like willing and obedient, I'll inherit the best of the land. Like, that sounds a lot better. So I gave my heart to the Lord. And then a week later, I'm actually at this beach right here and entered a pro-am and I ended up winning the contest. And the next day, everyone's like, you gotta go and surf in this bigger contest tomorrow. And I'm like, really? I don't know. I'm gonna get a beat down. Like, there's no way, I'm not gonna win. And anyway, so I went for it. I just drove up to Huntington Beach and sure enough, God would just send the waves. Make a long story short, I ended up winning the contest that day. And I'll never forget it. I was in my car driving back down here, blown away by God just handing me my dream, you know. And I just remembered that one scripture that says it's his kindness that leads us to repentance. And it's almost like he's so good to us, we'll want to stop blowing it, you know. And I wish I could say from that point forward, I never blew it, I never, you know, sinned. It's definitely not true, but I think from that point forward in my life, I truly fell in love with God and realized that he's for me, not against me. And so finding God or him finding me, it was like, it was just a natural reaction. Like, hey, you guys check this out. Like, God's real. There's a purpose for this whole life. You know, it was that simple. It wasn't some weird thing that I wanted to like, hey, push this on somebody. It was just like, hey, driving through Taco Bell or something. I was like, hey, like, thanks for the taco. And like, by the way, do you know that God's real, man? Like, he loves you. And I mean, it sounds cheesy, but that's honestly where I was. Because I was just excited to know that God was real and that we're not on this planet alone with no hope.